Hello and welcome back to Dark Souls 3, where we just lost 30,000 souls and want to get them back. So I am going to do something that I have not yet done. And that is swapping a ring out for a ring of sacrifice, because that way, if we die, the ring breaks, but our souls stay on the ground. Because we have been fighting some things that are capable of killing us if we're not careful here, so I figured, being extra prepared might be a good idea. So let's just stab these guys in the tukuses. Or we can drop him off there. So that's what caused the thing. Oh no, he's summoning more fire orbs. So I guess going down here is both a good and bad idea. Really missed? Alright, let's try and lead this guy back up here. Ow! I don't want to fight them down there. But then again, fighting them up here means those guys might join in, and generally there's just no good option here. Okay, one down. We've got some orbs trying to kill us. Always pleasant. No! He got another orb up. That's gonna make life very unpleasant. We've got far too many orbs trying to kill us. And vying for our... Okay, it's a good thing I wore that ring. Yeah. Simply too many orbs. Knocking him off the ledge was possibly the worst thing that could have happened. Yep. Ring of Sacrifice shattered. Okay, so it doesn't break and become repairable. It shatters. Might actually be worth it to not wear the ring, then. But instead, I'll just bank on not dying. Because, yeah, I'm sure there'll be times later on where we can make better use of the ring. No! No summoning more orbs! No summoning more orbs! No! Okay, that orb is gone now. So we didn't actually cross to the other side up here. I'm kind of curious what's over there. So let's fire orb this guy. Apparently we get one of his friends. Ooh, and it's a dagger one. Okay, one down. Okay, two down. So, that's right, there's still two of you. One more hit. There we are. Fire gem, okay. And then we can look across. No, we did cross. Right, there was a pit that we couldn't jump over. That was why we haven't explored fully up here. And I couldn't jump over the pit before, and I sure can't jump over it now. Ow. Okay, and now we're on the wrong side of this, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was the other side from whence we actually explored last time. So let's see if we can get rid of this. No, we cannot, and in fact, it is a terrible idea even being over there. Hey, buddy. Come over here so we can stay in our cover. Come on, buddy. Come on. You've got a cleaver, use it. Yeah, that's what I want to see. No, no, no. We got it up. Here, have a backstabbing. Okay, that's one guy gone, and thus one set of orbs gone. Letting these guys set up their orbs before we fight them is nasty. Because those orbs are nasty. Look how constantly that thing is firing. That is... yeah. We absolutely need this cover they've given us. So, ow. Let's go over here. So that way we can have some cover. And then we can stab him in the back a bunch. No! You have enough orbs. I do like that they keep on trying to summon orbs until they succeed or die. Because if they die, it makes life more pleasant. Okay, so that's where the oozes are. No, we were on the other side. Okay. I think. Or was it through here? I think, yeah, it was through here. Well, no, not exactly. Don't want to drop down there because then we'll have to fight a bunch of rats. We don't want to do that. But now I have my bearings. And we can use this to go up on this side. Which leads us to where? Oh, this is the side that we were on originally. Yeah, okay. So we want to go up on the other side if we want to see what else is up. So is there a way to go up on the other side? Or is there nothing but statues? Looks like there's nothing but statues, so... am I supposed to, like, strip down and maybe time things better to make that jump? Or is there going to be some other way to go up? I do not know. But yes, I recognize where we are now. And we are, in fact, kind of on the way to where we want to be. Let's get rid of these rats. Then we want to find our way down. But not down there. That's bad. No, we want to go down here. And we're now very close to where we died. In fact, if we take a left here, we'll get there. And it looks like we can even take this left without disturbing the rat. So, huzzah! Souls retrieved! Let's get our other ring back. And thus, we can continue on. But, I think I do want to deal with the rat so that I can take the left here and drop in on those two basilisks without needing to worry about getting like 50,000 basilisks on us. So it looks like those rats are content to stay where they are. Also, there's an item on this ledge, so that's another reason to drop here. Oh. Oh, hello. Well, let's try this. Decently effective, just... uh-oh. Need him to be where we can actually hit him. Alright, that's two basilisks down and one none the wiser. There. And of course there's no illusory wall there. Alright, let's fire orb this one. Just to get its attention. Alright. That's one more basilisk down. The more basilisks we can kill, the safer this place is. Hey, you two. Titanite scale, huh? We do need more of those. Okay. So is this the only basilisk remaining? It might be. Now it isn't. And let's use some heal aid. And then let's use our Ashen Estus. Alright. Just playing carefully here because we do have a bunch of souls. So, looks like this is the only path. This wall seems oddly undisturbed, but I guess it's for no real reason. So, what are we gonna find over here? Because we've got a path up, but also a path not up. Whoa, what was that? Hello? What's in here? Or was that just something loading? Oh. Hello. Are you an NPC? Why are you fighting me? Because I didn't see any you've been invaded by thing. Wow, he just... Oh. You're welcome? Now we've got to get back down here. That is not good. So, once again, let's get our Ring of Sacrifice. I guess having the ring shatter instead of be repairable is probably more in line with what they wanted the ring to do. It's definitely in service of making this game not like Dark Souls 2. Because in Dark Souls 2, you could just equip a Ring of Sacrifice and wear it forever, repairing it for just a few souls every time it broke, basically reducing the penalty for death. So yeah, in this game you can't do that. And... you know, I think since where we want to go is actually over to the right here, we can just ignore these guys, dash past them, and go over here. And maybe they won't follow. Hello, rat. Fine, bite me, jerk. Yep, trap ahead indeed. And they have that rat go that way to try and show you that there is another path. Because I'm pretty sure that rat tries to come and bite you from behind. They did a similar trick in Dark Souls 1. In the sewers, which I keep on saying this place really reminds me of. Alright. I think killing the giant rat and fighting the basilisks by themselves is indeed the correct thing to do here. Let's us skip some basilisks too. So yeah, I think this is definitely the way to go. Here, buddy. Oh. Got blocked. As long as these guys don't jump, they can't hit me. Which is fine by me. I enjoy not being hittable by basilisks. And their petrifying gas. Alright, come on. Hey, little guy. Bye, little guy. And there you go. So, seems we'll get back to our souls without issue here. That's good. Though, I don't know that I want to risk fighting that guy again, so I'm gonna go up above. Because he wasn't up there. And maybe this will lead to another bonfire, who knows. Who are you? There's a guy on the other end of the bridge. Is that a... looks like another Black Knight. And we've got more of this lava room. Hello. Yep, you're a Black Knight. If we had actually gotten a backstab there, I'm pretty sure this knight would have gone off the bridge. Goodbye. Though if he drops anything, he'll be hard-pressed to grab it. Looks like he didn't, which I will not complain about. So let's go across, see what he was guarding. What have we here? Okay. And there's a ladder. Where to, I don't know. But we'll climb it. Don't really have many other options. At least from this particular location. And I do wonder where it goes. It would be nice if it led to whoever was firing that giant ballista. And it's a long ladder, but not quite long enough to play Snake Eater. Oh, hello. Well, let's grab this, since we've seen it. Dragon Rider Bow. Interesting. Now, is that still as good a strength-scaling bow as it was in Dark Souls 2? Well, it doesn't do magic damage anymore. But it does scale with strength. So that might be our solution to the bow problem. Weighs 6.3, so it is heavier than the composite bow. But it does have much higher base damage and a bit higher range. Yeah. Better scaling, better base, slightly better range. If we can get the equip load for it, that'll be our bow of choice. Glad I found it. Though, what's a dragon rider doing there? I wonder. Or maybe it's someone who killed a dragon rider. Okay, so we are back here. And it looks like this will lead to whomever is operating the ballista. Okay, so those are not trustworthy cover. I was thinking they seemed a little flimsy. Wasn't expecting the ballista to just go straight through. Those are bone wheel skeletons. Why are there bone wheel skeletons? There's an item over there. It looks like this is beyond the reach of the ballista. Oh, looks like we're going into the reach of it, maybe. Is this just crossing the chasm that the bone wheels were on the other side of? It is. So it looks like this will indeed lead to the ballista's operator. Killing them will make life far more pleasant. Oh, bone wheels. These guys have been annoying since they first showed up. I forget whether that was Dark Souls 1 or Demon's Souls. I don't recall whether they were in Demon's Souls. But I know in Dark Souls 1 they were a big annoyance. And it looks like that was, in fact, the only method for crossing that chasm. And looks like nothing else over here. Nothing else over here. So we can see that hole that we got the ballista to make. That's nice. So I think I saw more bone wheels over this way. Yeah, well, no, those aren't bone wheels. They're just skeletons. That's good. Skeletons are far more pleasant than bone wheels. And they were very interested in this wall for reasons unknown. Okay. Oh, hello. Who are you? I see there's an enemy ahead. There's a couple, actually. Oh, they're fashion skeletons. Are they embered? They look kind of orange. Can we get them one at a time? That would be nice. I'd like to be able to lock onto one. That way I could do this. I like how it just fell straight over like that. So, these weapons it's got will actually do some damage through our shield. Not much, but some. Enough to be annoying. And I definitely don't want to get killed around here because we don't have any bonfires close to this particular location. I mean, we've got some down below, but none from whence we could easily get back here. Just gotta hit you one more time, and there it is. Okay. So there's the ballista. We've got some gears grinding away. And there's probably an enemy operating it. Or so I would think. Or maybe it's automatic. Praise the fine work. Yeah, I guess this is pretty fine work. And what's this all about? Yep, there is a hole ahead. We have already revealed it. Is that a lizard or an item way over there? Or is it just some shiny bit? Oh no. There's definitely... This thing's huge. There's definitely a lot to look around at here. Oh. Looks like these giants. They've died. This is a giant ballista, too. But let's go ahead and deactivate it. Other side? And that ends that threat, I suppose. Hopefully permanently. Another dead giant. Yeah, these are the type of giants that they were using at Sen's Fortress, which this place clearly is not. But still. It's interesting seeing so many things back from Dark Souls 1 in this general area. Especially things that don't seem to belong together. Yeah, let's go ahead and drop here. A little painful. So... I guess we drop again? Anything? Nope. And again? Still nothing. one more time. Still nothing. So I guess this is meant to just take us down to... They said cave ahead, and yeah, they mean this one, which we've already gone into. But let's go in again in case we missed a lizard, because I know the second lizard we paid more attention to than the first. So there might, in fact, be another lizard. Nope, no other lizards. Well. I am glad our exploration has come full circle like this, though there's still some things we haven't yet gotten our hands on. But... we are pretty close to a bonfire now. A bonfire that I would love to visit and use to go back to Firelink. Because we've got a lot of stuff we can use there. And then maybe we'll explore around the rest of this lake, grabbing the stuff that we were unable to get while being fired upon. This is definitely a pretty neat area, though. But let's head back to Firelink. And I'm gonna spend these souls. So, what you didn't see when I just fast-forwarded there was just me walking circles around this. Which I was doing because there was a particularly loud plane going by. And I did not wish to subject you fine folks to that. So let's give this guy the pyromancy tome thing. Oh, we've got several. Wow.
Ah, what have we here? A pyromancy tome from Izalith.
Yeah.
Then you found the home of pyromancy.
I have.
Brilliant. I will never curse being old and undead again. Now, show it here, quickly. Let us channel them together.
All right.
The primal pyromancy is known only to old Master Salaman.
And how about this one?
What have we here? By the gods, this inscription reads, Quelana, the ancient deity, one of the witches of Izalith. The last of them who wandered the lands. Then she must have returned to Izalith after all.
Oh, so it wasn't the Fair Lady.
To say, I cannot accept this. Quelana's pyromancies are for witches and must be learned from a mistress.
Oh.
But thank you for allowing me to peer upon such a thing.
All right.
If only I were a woman.
Huh. If only. Well, how about this
I'm
one?
I'm afraid I cannot accept this. This pyromancy tome is dark. And delves into the depths of men where an untouchable flame resides. I cannot comprehend this myself, let alone teach it to you.
Okay.
It is a spell forbidden in the Great Swamp, and nearly everywhere else too. Only one terribly afflicted or burdened by deep sorrow could begin to understand this.
Okay. Well, what pyromancies can we learn now? Ooh. Yes, please. Let's take this. Chaos Storm I'll actually not take. It's very expensive and not terribly useful in most cases.
Do not be gone for long.
Don't
what
worry.
What is a teacher without a pupil?
Don't know, man. So, let's look at what we can transpose, because we did get the demon soul.
Aha, thou returned, and of two.
Yep, I have. So now we can get the demon's great axe. But don't necessarily want that right now. Or we could get the demon's fist. But we don't want that either. Is there anything we do want? Doesn't... Oh, right, the Wolf Knight's Greatsword we kind of wanted. Kind of. But we have neither the strength nor the dex to wield it. So, we'll leave it here for now. There'll come a time when we've got enough souls to get those levels and wield it. And buy it. So, let's upgrade our stuff and then we'll level. Because we did get a lot of Titanite. Oh, do we have any ash? I don't think we do, but...
How may I?
Oh, we do.
Gracious. Passing fine ash thou hast given. Let this ash... I only hope thee...
Maybe they will, maybe they won't. Let's see them. I wish there was something to inform you just what was newly added. But, oh, Titanite shards, we can buy those now. But now we've got 49 of them. And is there anything else of particular value? This canvas talisman's got a higher spell buff than our chime talisman. Which is weird. Because it's just canvas. Is there something special about it? No, it doesn't look like there's anything particularly special about this one. But with higher spell buff, let's take it. And we... Oh, we can make Undead Legion stuff. Or is... That mask looks like the mask of the lost sinner, but it's not. Oh, and we can make Wolnir's crown. Does that do anything special? Doesn't look like it. Huh. So, does this imply that the crowns we went after in the Dark Souls 2 DLC became this? Or is it referring to other crowns? Don't know.
Ashen one.
Yeah. So, let's equip our new talisman. Wonder what Unfaltering Prayer does versus Gentle Prayer. Increases poise while casting miracles. Not particularly worthwhile. Gentle Prayer can be nice, I guess, but in most cases I think we're better off just casting heals with our FP. So yeah, Canvas Talisman's the way to go. Same weight, though. I'd imagine it would be lighter, considering the sacred chime is made of metal. But whatever. Okay, now to upgrade our stuff.
Tis good, tis what needs me.
Ooh, and can we... No, we don't have Estus shards. We have bone shards. So, let's reinforce some weaponry. Specifically, this weaponry. As much as we can. Twice as good. Twice is good, not twice as good. Just in case. Sometimes I get lazy with my pronunciation. And we can upgrade Wolnir's Holy Sword again. 201 plus 43, whereas this is 185 plus 90, so... It'd still take more to get better than our broadsword. Quite a bit more. Just looking. Do you have anything else that scales nicely with strength that isn't massive? It's not looking like we do. Okay. And Just checking on other infusions. Okay, so this makes it scale more with faith, but it doesn't make it do any holy damage or anything. So we actually would get more out of the scaling with refined right now than we do with what it's got, the heavy. But since heavy adds the 7 points to its base, we're still currently better off with heavy, just barely. And raw is a downgrade. Crystal is probably a downgrade. Crystal adds scaling, though, which most things that add an element seem to not, judging by this, and this, and this. Well, no, this keeps scaling. So, we are at the we're not. We're still about 50 points of damage behind. But we might still be better off for not having to go through 2 resistances. Not sure. And yeah, we're better off than we would be with no imbue. Because we'd gain 12 points of raw in exchange for 21 points of scaling. Okay. And of course, can't repair the rings. Got it.
Pretty be careful. I don't want to see.
So, I was thinking of something. What was it? Don't know. How much does it take to level right now? 13k. So we might be able to sell enough souls to level one more time. On top of what we've got. Ooh, yes. Yes, we can. So this should do it by itself, but I'll sell one of these just to be sure.
Ashen one. Be sure.
All right, leveling time.
Welcome home, speak.
I would like to level up.
Then touch the take nourishment.
Okay. So, doing more attunement is silly. Wait, what? It really goes up that fast? Well, we can use the one other soul, and then we'll have enough to level 3 times. Use this, then we have enough for 3 levels.
Welcome home, speak. Very well, then take not.
Okay, where was I throwing stats? I was throwing stats at strength. And I think I had 25 as my goal. So it looks like 3, 4, 3. But no, let's just... let's stay at 25 for now. I was thinking of doing more faith so that I could learn more pyromancies. But I don't think I actually need that. Whereas more vitality would certainly help. We're butting up against the equip limit and we want to be able to equip a good bow. But more vigor would also be good, because that's still 40 HP per level. That's a good chunk. Like, a really good chunk. That's about 5% off of the new total. Yeah, vigor is really strong in this game. But I think let's do a bit more vitality, because we do want to be able to equip a better bow. Yeah, we'll pump vitality up a bit. Don't know where to, but a bit.
ash and may the flame.
Though I probably should have kept some souls so that I could upgrade my pyro flame. But maybe this'll let us do that. I don't know how much it takes per pyro flame upgrade. Let's find out together.
Ah, the iron.
Okay, yeah, it's actually pretty cheap. So let's do that and that. Can't do it one more time, but still twice as good. Wonder if Grey Rat's got anything new to say these days.
Oh, hello, you hand in one.
Looks like he hasn't.
Goodbye. Oh, this be.
Wonder if he'll want to go pillaging again anytime soon. And I wonder if you've got anything to say. Well, it looks like she sells an infinite number of purging stones, so that's nice.
Our lord, and knows thou of a maid named Anri?
Maybe.
She is hollow, and will join thee in wedlock. A fellow of mine guides her at this moment. When the time is ripe, thou mayst make thy salutations.
Is that so?
For what lord taketh no spouse? Our lord and Lee, knows thou she a fool? Till we meet again, may the dark.
Okay. Is that something I even want to do? And who was Anri? I think we've met Anri. Was she the lady who hung out up here, or is she the miracle lady? I don't think she's the miracle lady.
Mercy.
Sorry.
Please.
I didn't mean to hurt you.
Champion of Ash, do you wish to hear a tale?
Your arena.
You know, in my home of Kari, I would be pleased to show that, to be honest,
okay.
If I had a...
we know.
Have a pleasant, I pray.
Sorry for landing on you. Okay, well, unless there's someone else to talk to, which it doesn't look as though there is, that's going to be it for this episode. Join us next time when we explore some more places, like figuring out what is so crab-guarded at the lake and why. See you then, friends.